Hey, Mountain Church Life Groups, I'm so excited that you guys are gathering around the valley this week to get together and encourage each other. You're probably going to share a meal and pray together, talk about what's going on in your lives, encourage each other, pray for each other. At some point, be getting into the Word as you watch this video, and that's what this video is about. We're just looking at Scripture. We've been going through a series of the wisdom literature in the Bible. We've been looking at words of wisdom from Moses and David and Solomon. And this week, we want to look at a passage from the wisest of wise dudes, Solomon, in Ecclesiastes. So we're going to go to chapter 1 of Ecclesiastes and hit verse 1. Here it goes. The words of the preacher, the son of David, king in Jerusalem. He says this, vanity of vanities, all is vanity, or meaningless in other translations. What does man gain by all the toil at which he toils under the sun? A generation goes and a generation comes, but the earth remains forever. The sun rises and the sun goes down and hastens to the place where it rises. The wind blows to the south and goes round to the north. Round and round goes the wind, and on its circuits the wind returns. All streams run to the sea, but the sea is not full. To the place where the streams flow, they flow there again. All things are full of weariness. A man cannot utter it. The eye is not satisfied with seeing, nor the ear filled with hearing. What has been is what will be, and what has been done is what will be done. And there is nothing new under the sun. Is there a thing of which it is said, see, this is new? It has been already in the ages before us. There is no remembrance of former kings, nor will there be any remembrance of latter things yet to be among those who come after. The whole point as this book opens, this writing of Solomon, is to talk about the things of this earth. And he uses this phrase, everything under the sun. And when he uses that phrase, he's talking about everything that we see, the things that are here in this life, the physical things that we see. And so he starts talking about the kingdoms of the earth and the men and the women of the earth. And he's talking about ideas and philosophies that come from men and women, that none of those things will remain. At some point, they become old. At some point, they pass away. And so he's talking about the futility of this earth in comparison to God and his eternal perspective. And there's nothing, I think, more obvious to that in our lives and how easy it is to get wrapped up in that than probably our vehicles. The vehicles that we drive. I think about this all the time because when I was in high school, this kid pulled up onto our campus and he had the brand new car that everybody wanted. And it was in the year 1995, it was a 1995 Ford Explorer Sport. It was incredible. Everybody loved it and it was the coolest car in the whole school and it was brand new and he had this incredible sound system in it and every leather seats and we just couldn't believe it. I drive a 1998 Ford Explorer right now, and let me tell you, it is not the coolest thing when I pull up to pick up my kids from school, nor is it in our parking lot. It very rarely is it the coolest vehicle wherever I am. It's a 98 Ford Explorer. It doesn't take long for things that were once the coolest or once the newest thing to become the old thing, and pretty soon we're driving around in these vehicles that, although they once were worth $20,000, $30,000, $40,000, $50,000, now we couldn't sell it for $2,000 or $3,000. But that's the way things go in this life. Everything under the sun, it depreciates in value. A brand new car, the moment you drive it off of the lot, it's already worth less than it was when you bought it an hour ago. And that's the way things work here under the sun. That's the way things work on this earth, the physical things. And that's the way God designed it, because there's something greater, there's something better that we all long for. And when the value of our car or the value of our home depreciates, or when the things that we once enjoyed no longer bring that same satisfaction, it reveals to us a deeper desire for God. It reveals to us something that we need, and that is the presence of our God in our lives. I love what the Apostle Paul says. He talks about in 2 Corinthians chapter 4. He gives us some insight in how we can do this and have a perspective that's not locked in on the earthly things. As beautiful as this is, this town that we live in, and the mountains that we can see around, we're standing on top of the roof at the church right now as we film this video and just seeing the beauty of this earth that God's given us. As awesome as that is, it pales in comparison to him. And at some point, this will all be gone and God will remain. And Paul says, in talking about the things that we deal with in life and how we how we can work through those and how we can find perspective in God, he says this: do not lose heart. For our outer self is wasting away. Our inner self is being renewed day by day. The outward, it wastes away. And we feel that. I'm 41 now, and there are definitely signs in my life that things have changed. I went for a run the other day, a walk run, mostly walk. And it was a lot harder than it was last year and way harder than it was 10 years ago. That's the way life works. Things get harder and more difficult. And Paul is saying the outer self is wasting away, but the inner is renewed day by day. And then he finishes with this. He says, "For this light momentary affliction is preparing for us an eternal weight of glory beyond all comparison, as we look not to the things that are seen, but to the things that are unseen. For the things that are seen are transient or temporary, but the things that are unseen are eternal." And really, that's what I want to encourage us with this week, is that we would be looking for and locking in on things that are eternal, things that we cannot see. So we have to have the eyes of God to see those things. And it's really easy to get wrapped up in the things that we see around us, the depreciation of our car in our home, or the way things are working in our relationships, or the way our society is going, or the way politics is leaning, or all of those things. And we get super wrapped up in all that, and God is calling us to look at things that are eternal. Don't look at the external, look at the eternal. Lock in on that, and that's where you will find that your heart is satisfied and fulfilled and strengthened and encouraged and lifted up when you lock in on those things. So I would just encourage you guys in your groups this week as you meet, just talk about those things. What are the external things that so easily wrap you up? And then talk about how you can focus on eternal things. Help each other see the eternal things in life. Help each other see where God is working and moving. And maybe if you have time, go to Scripture and open up the Bible and search for Scripture that would support the idea of God being eternal and lasting and the things of this earth fading away. So God bless you guys. I love you. I hope you have a great time together. We'll see you soon.